Hi guys, this short tutorial today is based on creating one audience for your Mailchimp campaigns. This tutorial is going to be really great for anybody that wants to stay on the free version and also is not going to send to more than 2,000 contacts in any calendar month, but also not in total have 2,000 contacts on an audience. Okay, so great for smaller businesses. And, you know, I absolutely love Mailchimp, but definitely over the last few months, they've become more focused on generating income. So what they've actually done now is changed their pricing structure. And if you look here for the free version now, one of the key things that's changed is this here. And the fact that for audiences, you can only have one audience on the free version. But what is good is you can still have the segmentation. And not many people will realise that you can have one audience group in your emails. You just need to be a little bit clever about how you do it. And this is all about planning up front what you're going to be sending to people and who you're going to be sending to. So if you want to stay on the free version and you know you're not going to send to more than 2,000 contacts, then let's get going. What you do want to do first is open Google Sheets or Microsoft Excel and actually create your database. Now, you have to think really hard first off about who you're going to send to and what you're going to send to them, okay? Because it is all based on the fields that you create in this audience list. So, in my example here, obviously you want an email field and a first name. You might even have a company, you know, if you're business to business, or, you know, you could have something else in there like a region or anything that you feel that, you know, would group people together. And maybe it could be something that they've purchased, that kind of thing. You might have a telephone number in there. On my version, I have. And what I'm going to do here is it's something, for example, if I'm in marketing, I'm going to be sending out an email to businesses and I've grouped them by profession and by the package that they're on with my company. So for profession, we have people like working in marketing, accountancy, printing. And also here, there's a bronze, silver and a gold membership package. So I might send emails out to people that are only on the bronze package, and then people that are on the gold package might get more information or additional downloads and content. Also, I may just want to send information that's relevant to companies that are in the printing industry. So again, I've created a field for that because I think, you know, there may be stuff that I talk to the printing industry about that I wouldn't talk to the accountancy industry about. So you've got to plan this. You've got to really think about what you're going to send to people and how you're going to group those people up, because basically an audience is a group of people. But what you can do here is have a number of audiences within one audience. Hopefully this makes sense right now. It can get quite confusing, but I'm keeping it as simple as I can. Think about your audience first, create a field for what you want to segment by, and then you're saving it as a .csv file, okay, which is your comma delimited here. I'm just going to put that on my desktop, call it list, and that is my list done. Now, what you then want to do is log in, which I have done here. And if we go to audience, this is where you are then going to either upload or create your audience. Now, if you're going to create an audience for the first time, there's typically a little tab up here that says create audience, and you would click on that tab. But obviously, because I've got an account that's already up and running, I'm going to go to the audience that I have created, which is, for example, this client attraction program, which at the moment I have no subscribers in. Okay, so you will come to this page when you have create audience, and it will ask you to import your contacts. So click on that and it will ask you what you actually importing it as. And for us, it's a CSV or tab delimited text file, and continue. Then it will literally ask you, you know, where is it? So you would have to then delve into your files and find it on your computer. I've put it on my desktop, so that's my list there. Okay. Then you would continue to match, and this is where you're then bringing in your fields that you've just created. And each field is a different group or a different audience of people that you can send to. So for my example here, I'm going to edit and save that, save it as first name. And this is the reason it's pulling these in here, by the way, is because I put them in as column names. If you don't put column names in here, then you'll have to just click on this down arrow and create a new field and type it in manually. But if you actually put it in your document first off, it will pull them in. So it's pulled in the first name. Oh, prime example here. We go down here, create a new field. It's pulled it in there. Okay, company. Telephone number. Again, it's not listed it, but it has just pulled it in there. If I tap on that, it has standards up here. Save that. And you basically do this for each one until you have finished your list. Now, depending on how many fields you've put in, this could take a bit of time, but do try and keep it pretty concise, because you don't want to get overwhelmed with the number of fields that you've put into your document. If you're only sending to 2,000 people, you shouldn't have too many fields, really. And that's for silver. And then I've got my gold. Okay. So we've saved all these fields now. Okay. And we're going to continue to organise that. And it will bring in all the people that I've put on the list. So obviously I said they're subscribed to it. You know the deal with subscriptions and dropping people in your emails. I'm not going to go into that right now. GDPR stuff for Europe and things. Right. It's going to import 8 of my columns, which is correct. And it just brings it right through. So my 4 contacts have been added. I can have a look at them. That's absolutely correct. And all my fields are here. So now we can actually create a campaign and segment down this list. So we have this one audience list here. So then if we go to create, depending on what you want to go on, but we're doing email because most people do that, and just call it a test. Then the first one you're looking at here is add recipients. So you may just have this one list in. I've got a number, but this is the list that you've just created. Now, this is where it gets a bit of fun. You have this box here, segment or tag, group or new segment. Okay, now think back to your list here. You might want to have it open somewhere else so you remember what fields you've created. But on this occasion, I'm going to send to the people on my list that are part of the bronze package. Now, as you'll see here, it all depends on what you've put in these fields. And I've got a Y and an N for yes and no. So I'm wanting to send it to people that are the bronze package. So that's a yes. Okay. So I go here and I put in here all these fields that I've done in the merge fields. I'm going to choose my bronze is a Y, because that is what I have in this field. Okay. And if you update the recipient count, we have 3. So let's double check it. 1, 2, 3. So the only person that's not going to get this email is this person here, because they've got an N in it. So it could be, again, that you actually want to send it to people that are from a specific company. And for that, again, you'd have to know what you had in here. But if I'm going to send it to everyone that's an Apple, you have to type it in absolutely as it's seen in your field. We've got 1, which is this one here. See what I'm doing? Yep. So that's if you want to send to any one particular variable. You can send it to any of the fields here. And this is why it's so important that you plan what you're doing with your audience and your newsletters, because any field you put in here will appear under here in your merge fields. Okay. If you don't put it in, you can't segment by it, basically. Now, what we could do is do 2 or 3 variables. So what we might want to do here is say, I want to send an email newsletter out to anyone that is in the accountancy profession, but is also signed up to the gold package. Okay. So what you do need to do here is change this contacts match here to all. And what you're doing is saying, listen, it has to be this, but it also has to be the other one that you're going to add in under here. Okay. So we're going to say that the, let's have a look, profession is accountancy. Okay. And the gold package is a yes. Okay. And what this will do now is actually say, right, well, how many people do we have in this one to be able to send it to? Okay. And what it's found is it's matched to two contacts. So let's have a look. We've got two Y's in this field and two accountants here. Now, if I was to put an N in there, an update, we'd get nothing because obviously our two accountancy companies are both yeses. It is just an absolutely fantastic tool. You can put another variable in. Just make sure that you've put all and not any, okay, on this particular occasion, because it'll do, they're either an accountant in the accountancy profession or there's a no in gold. Okay, so that can get quite confusing. But you can do and or on these ones. It's a great tool. But what I'm trying to show you here is that you can get away with one audience. You just need to really get to grips with who you're sending to and what kind of newsletters you're going to send out. So plan it in advance. Create a field for it in your Excel or your Google Sheets or whatever. Save it as a .csv file. Upload it as your new audience. Confirm all of those field names so you understand what each one of them is, so you can actually do the merge tags on them. And then when you create your campaign up here, instead of all subscribers, which is what it comes as typically, you are going to this group or segment list. And if you have created the field for it, it will appear under here. And like I say, if you want everybody that's on the bronze package, because you're going to send them some information, then there we go. We've got three, one, two, three. If you want everyone whose email is a certain email, you can send it that way. Everyone whose profession is marketing. Oh, it does do this sometimes, it's quite frustrating. Then we should have the one there, which is this top one. And you can do your and here. They're in marketing and they're on the bronze package. Okay. There you go. And that is how you can pull in 2,000 contacts in one audience and be able to send to different audiences within that audience. I've always done it that way. I think there's actually a video on my channel already about segmenting lists, so I've been doing it for quite a while. But because there's a push now, there's a financial cost to smaller businesses especially, to then have to upgrade on MailChimp to the next version, which is paid for. I just think it's even more important that you just plan what you're doing, because you know you can save yourself nearly $10 a month by doing that, just by creating this one audience. If you've got any questions, post it in the comments below and I'll get back to you. Hopefully you find this of use. And yeah, good luck with it all. Let me know how you get on. Thank you very much. See you at the next video. Bye.